My name is Charlie Mole, demonstrating how I use the Travel Sax 2 in Logic as a wind controller. The first thing you need to do is go into the phone app and make sure you turn the volume down so you're not getting the sound coming out of this. Set the MIDI channel to, I set it to 7. Then you have to plug in your MIDI cable. You could probably just start playing, but it's worth just checking in the environment, which you go to by pressing Apple 0 normally. Go to clicks and ports, and then you'll see here Travel Sax. So at least you know it's Logic's recognizing it. Create an instrument, which I've just done here, which I will call Swarm Sax Demo. Here we go to controller mapping, MIDI mapping. So expression, it's on defaults to 11, but I'm going to put that at 7 because that's what this is putting out. 7 there. That's that. We go back into here, controller mapping, MIDI mapping, and we go to vibrato depth. Again, I'm going to put that to 7. Theoretically, that's all you have to do. If I start playing, there you are. So you can see the expression and the vibrato going up. Okay, so then what I would do would be to make it sound nice, to add some reverb. I also created my own I sampled my own sax into Logic Sampler. Logic Sampler, which looks like this. And I was quite pleased with the results. I tried to do loads of different velocity layers, but that got kind of complicated because every time you crossfade into a new dynamic layer, you get sort of phasing and you hear both sounds at once. So I just stuck to 2. Sounds like this. I'll play it in context with some music. Taxi Driver. So, you know, it's a lot of fun to play because you kind of feel like you're playing a real sax, which is what I really love about Travel Sax. Okay, I'm now going to show you how I create a horn section. So I've set all the individual tracks up already. So I've got a Swarm Alto. There it is. Swarm Tenor. Swarm baritone and audio modeling the trumpet. I'll just quickly show you a little trick I do with the trumpet. To basically get the vibrato, get around the vibrato issue, because if you put the vibrato amount and the dynamics on the same CC, if you play really loudly, the vibrato is just going to go wow, 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 like this. So it's fine if you're playing softly, but as soon as you get loud. Yeah, so I've created a modifier in Logic, which you do by just going to here and click modifier. And I'm inputting my CC7 volume and I'm reassigning it to breath control. And then in the trumpet, I have gone to controller remapping. And there I've got CC2, which is the vibrato intensity, CC7, the dynamics. So, and what this does, so obviously it changes the level at which I blow, changes the vibrato volume, but you can scale it with this thing here. So if you didn't have it, the vibrato just goes crazy. So you can get around that by doing this little trick and set that somewhere like that. And then, and it sounds more realistic. Okay, so having done that, I will now select all my horn section people and create a track stack. Create a track stack, a summing stack, boom. And that puts them all in this one folder, which I will call CM Horns.